Dr. Rosa Gragg was a trailblazer. During a time when there was a lot of legal racism, she created opportunities for African-American women, leading the way by quite literally showing them when one door closes, no matter how unfair or just plain wrong, you find another door. And when you can't find another door, you build one. Stevie Wonder, Rosa Parks, and Aretha Franklin all have Detroit streets named after them. Now, Dr. Rosa L. Gragg. She's not famous, but her contributions to the city of Detroit are just as important.
She paved the way for a woman of color in this community, in this neighborhood, and really around the country. She was an advisor to Martin Luther King Jr., and she was a true civil rights activist and fought for equality and justice.
It's what happened to this house in the corner of Ferry and Brush that makes the new street name so significant. In 1941, as president of the Detroit Association of Colored Women's Clubs, Dr. Gragg chipped in to buy a clubhouse, a place to hold meetings and classes. After taking a second mortgage out on her home, selling her car, and having the sale on the new clubhouse approved, she was told African Americans weren't allowed on Ferry Street, which meant the clubhouse couldn't be used.
But she did not take no for an answer, and she continued to fight.
So she had the front door on Ferry Street removed, leaving only the original front porch. Then she built a new door on the side of the house on Brush Street, where African Americans were allowed.
They don't give you at the seat of the table, you create your own seat. And I feel like Dr. Gragg's is an example of that. She did not let no stop her.
And the clubhouse still stands today, educating and empowering women in Detroit 80 years later.
I was inspired by her history, and I'm sure everyone who reads about her will be inspired as well too. So I'm just grateful to have her there.
From here on out, the street Rosa Gragg was not allowed to be on will forever bear her name. In Detroit, Jennifer Ann Wilson, 7 Action News.